Our lips shouldn't touch.
Move over, darling.
Oh, baby. Move closer to me. I've had all that I can stand. Take hold of me with your hand.
Jack Nitzsche is a name that anyone who has a comprehensive collection of rock records will have seen as an arranger, producer, or songwriter. Yet, despite a career spanning some 20 years, you remain an enigmatic figure. Is this deliberate?
Is it deliberate? An enigmatic figure, like a, you mean the low profile?
Very low profile.
It's to some extent deliberate. I never cared about that random notes scene.
Mm-hmm.
But that's hard to answer.
Do you shun publicity?
Yeah, generally. I don't think it does very much good. I think it can hurt.
Well, let's do some damage.
Okay.
The last 20 years. You arrived in Los Angeles from
Michigan,
where you'd studied music.
I just had taken piano lessons with a local teacher in a small rural town in Michigan, and learned to play clarinet in the high school band.
And you came to Los Angeles too?
To go to college at Westlake College of Music, which was one of two schools in the country that took an approach of so-called modern harmony as opposed to traditional harmony. And Berkeley of Boston was the other. They're still in business. Westlake went out of business shortly after I arrived. I didn't last very long in college because they were a real jazz school, and I liked rock and roll.
This was in which year?
I guess late 56 is when I really started going door to door and trying to hustle songs, you know, and meet people and get into it. I was in business with, we had an office together, H.B. Barnum and I, who was an arranger. I was a copyist for him. I learned how to copy there. I also learned a lot about arranging by copying his charts. Between he and Sonny Bono, I was able to hang out around studios and sessions and met people. But the first actual job came, I think, in late 58 with Art LeBeau at Original Sound Records. I did everything in that job. I mean, I was at order desk, took care of the pressing, the inventory, swept the place up, did all the mailing, and produced and wrote.
An exhilarating experience?
Oh, God, it was awful. $225 a month. And Gracia was pregnant, and I asked him for a $25 a month raise, and he said, find another job. It was exhilarating. I'm glad that it happened. I learned a lot about the record business. I was just thrilled to be part of it.